Suspension bridges are able to span very long distances. While they may look like delicate structures, they're actually able to hold tremendous amounts of weight.
Hi, my name is Sofia Puerto, and I'm a civil engineer. I decided to become a civil engineer because I knew they were involved with really cool projects. Civil engineers can build, design small roads, huge highways, tall buildings, smaller houses, and my favorite of all, bridges. I've been involved with the design and study of bridges since very early in my career, and I hope I could teach you a little bit about them.
So there are many kinds of bridges. What is so special about a suspension bridge?
Suspension bridges are usually built when engineers want to span across really long distances. They're actually much better about going across long distances than any other type of bridge.
Did you know the longest suspension bridge in the United States is the Verrazano Narrows Bridge in New York City? It is 13,700 feet long and carries almost 200,000 cars every day.
There are two main components in a suspension bridge: cables and towers. There are usually two main cables in a suspension bridge. They go from the start of the bridge over one or two towers until the end of the bridge. The main task of the towers is to help the cables support all the way. Now, it's called a suspension bridge because the roadway is actually hanging or suspended from the cables. The main cables of a suspension bridge are extremely important because they're directly supporting the deck or the roadway with all the people, cars, and trucks going across the bridge. They have to be both very strong and flexible to support all this weight. There are also smaller cables that are called suspender cables or hangered cables that link the roadway with the main cables.
If these bridges are so big, how do you distribute all the weight in the bridge? Imagine you are trying to move a really big bucket filled with water. It's so large and heavy you can't move it at all. What do you do? What if you used a lot of smaller buckets instead of one big bucket? It'll be a lot easier to move when the weight is spread out, right? This concept is called weight distribution, which is used a lot in engineering. By spreading out the work over a larger area, it makes it easier to move heavy things.
So there are smaller hanger cables or suspender cables that carry a little bit of the weight of the roadway at a time.
Suspension bridges are really long. How do they work?
Before getting into the details, let's review what a tension force and a compression force are.
A tension force is when you pull something, like the rope in tug of war. The opposite is a compression force, which is when you push or squeeze something together, like pinching your fingers together. Cables only work under tension. If you take a cable or a piece of string and push the ends together, it bends. If you try pulling the ends in opposite directions, the cable or string becomes tight to hold things.
The cables of a suspension bridge are working under tension because the roadway is hanging from them, whereas the pillars or towers are working under compression because they're holding the cables. So the cables are trying to squeeze these towers into the ground.
What's the longest and strongest bridge you can make? Try to build your own suspension bridge on Curiosity Machine.